Today we're going to talk about water hyacinth. It's a floating invasive aquatic species that was introduced into Louisiana in the late 1800s at the World's Fair. It has spread quickly throughout the southeastern United States and other parts of our country. It is known for its purple showy flower, its long root system. Here's some very dark roots. It has the small, more confined roots right here, up close of the purple flower that is known in the aquarium trade, and that's how it gets its spread because people like to put it in their ponds, but it quickly gets out of hand. It starts off as one plant, then eventually it fragments into other plants. So we see a daughter plant, a couple of them here, that breaks off. Eventually, that's how it gets spread through fragmentation from water body to water body, sometimes purposeful through the aquarium trade, but also through use of boats and accidental spread in wildlife as well. It has a long stalk, a shiny, fibrous leaf. Water hyacinth, it looks harmless, but as you can see here with the bull hyacinth versus the smaller, what we call button hyacinth, a few plants can quickly turn into a large infestation. And if you have a small pond, eventually you lose everything and it's gonna impact wildlife and your fisheries, so your water's not able to be used anymore. So any of the vegetation that's below is gonna get blocked out with light. And then you can also see issues with mosquitoes because we create stagnant conditions where the water's not flowing. And then we know diseases come with the mosquitoes. It's a difficult, not just control, but it's also difficult to remove, and it causes many issues environmentally with our aquatic systems, both ponds all the way up to lakes. There are several herbicides that we can use to control this floating invasive species. For more information, please visit the LSU Ag Center or the Aquatic Plant Control Research Program's website.